Welcome to MiniEM. Here's how to do a slit lamp exam in the emergency department. Before you bring your patient over, get the slit lamp set up. Make sure the lamp itself is plugged into a wall outlet, and there should be an on button on the table, so switch that on. Turn both of your brightness dials all the way up, and you can always dial them back later. Find the light filter and flip it to the open circle, which is a bright yellow light. If you flip this all the way to the right, you'll get a green light, which you should never use. And one common mistake is thinking that this is the thing you use for the Flourescein exam. We'll show you that later. Use this vertical knob to make your light beam taller. If you turn it all the way, it's going to turn blue, and this is the blue light that you'll use for Flourescein exams. Use this horizontal knob to make your light beam narrow. Make sure your light source is directly in front of your eyepieces. If it's off-center, rotate the entire light source until this dial reads 90 degrees. That's how you know you're straight on. Pull the eyepieces close together and then slowly pull them apart until you see one image with both of your eyes open. Set the eyepiece focus to zero, even if you're currently wearing contacts or glasses. The only time you need to change this is if you're currently wearing glasses and you want to take them off for your exam. If that's the case, set the focus to whatever your glasses prescription is. Set the magnification to 10 times to start. You can increase this later as needed. Turn the screw on the base of the machine to unlock it. When you have your patient sitting there, you're going to push the base around until you get a gross view of their eye. The joystick is what you use for fine focus. Push it left to go left and right to go right. Push it away from you to go forward and pull it towards you to come backwards. Spin it clockwise or counterclockwise to move it up and down. Now get your patient into the chair. Raise the chair up and down for their comfort. Raise the table up to meet your patient by pulling this lever. Have them rest their chin here and place their forehead flush against this bar. Find the black mark on the frame. You want this to line up with your patient's lateral canthus. Rotate this knob right below the black mark until it's lined up. Once you've got them in good position, turn this knob to lock the table into place. Now you're ready to examine your patient. Start with a general scan of their eye from outer to inner corner. Examine their lids, their lashes, corneal surface, sclera, conjunctiva, pupil, and iris. Now examine the anterior chamber. Swing the light source out laterally so that it hits the eye at an oblique angle. The fluid in the anterior chamber is the aqueous humor, and this should be totally transparent. Here's some examples of abnormal findings in the anterior chamber. A hyphema is when there's blood in the anterior chamber, and this is usually due to trauma. Hypopyon or hypopyon is also called endophthalmitis, and it's basically just pus within the anterior chamber. So this usually represents an infection. Iritis is the same thing as anterior uveitis, and this is when there's a cloudy anterior chamber, which is usually due to the presence of inflammatory cells. This is sometimes called the cell and flare or fog and headlights appearance of the normally clear aqueous humor. Lastly, turn on the blue light by turning the top knob on your light source all the way. Stain their eye with Flourescein dye, and you can check out our separate video on that. And then look for corneal abrasions, ulcers, lacerations, foreign bodies, keratitis, and cytalsine. All right, that was the slit lamp exam. Check out the rest of our mini EM library for some more eye education.